In this video, we're going to explore some of the Docker features available in IntelliJ IDEA. If you want a refresher on Docker, check out my Intro to Docker video linked in the description. First, let's set up IntelliJ IDEA to work with Docker. You'll want to make sure Docker is installed and running on your machine. If you haven't installed Docker yet, I've included a link to the Docker installation page in the description. In my case, I have Docker installed on my Windows machine and I can see the Docker icon in my taskbar. In IntelliJ IDEA, Docker features are available through the Docker plugin. If you're using IntelliJ IDEA Ultimate, the Docker plugin is bundled and enabled by default. If you're using IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition, you can install the plugin from Marketplace. Since I'm currently using Ultimate, the plugin is already installed. Now let's configure IntelliJ IDEA so it can connect to my machine's Docker installation. I'll go to my Docker settings. Here I can click on the Add button. IntelliJ IDEA detects that I'm running Docker for Windows and sets the rest of the fields for me. This will work similarly for other operating systems. Once IntelliJ IDEA is able to connect to my Docker daemon, I see a connection successful message at the bottom. So I can click OK. We can now see Docker listed in my services window and I can click Connect. If you run into any problems on this step, make sure your Docker settings are correct and verify that Docker is up and running on your machine. Now that I have Docker connected to IntelliJ IDEA, I can see any images or containers running on Docker. I currently have no images or containers running on Docker, so let's go ahead and pull an image by clicking on the Pull Image button, or you can click on the Images node. If you're using IntelliJ IDEA 2021 or later versions, you can use code completion to get a list of all images available in your configured registries. By default, IntelliJ IDEA will show you a list of images available on Docker Hub without needing to configure it. One of my favorite ways to use Docker is to set up a database. Docker makes it quick and easy. For example, let's say we want to get a MySQL database set up. I'll select the MySQL image from my list, then I'll pull the image by pressing Ctrl Enter. We see that IntelliJ IDEA starts pulling the image and we can view our logs in the services window. Once the pull is complete, we can now see the latest MySQL image under my images list. If you want to view any of your images information, you can easily do so by clicking on the image. You'll see your image's ID, tags, data was created, and size. Let's create a MySQL container from our image. We can do that by right-clicking on the image and selecting Create Container. IntelliJ IDEA will prompt us for any additional configuration. We can edit the configuration name, I'll call it MySQL Config. In the next section, we can specify all the options we would like to use when creating our container. These are the options you would have passed in with your Docker run command. I'll give my container a name and call it MySQL Container. You'll notice that by default, IntelliJ IDEA only displays the container name field. If you want to specify more options, you can click on Modify Options and enable additional options. For MySQL containers, we are required to pass in a root password for the database. We will enable the environment variable option, then specify the root password environment variable. I'll also specify the MySQL database environment variable, which will create a database for me when the container starts. I'll call it MyDB. I also want to bind some ports so I can reach the MySQL database outside the container. I'll click Modify Options and choose Bind Ports. Then I'll specify 3306 for my host port and my container port. Now we're ready to create our container, so I'll click Run. As the process starts, you'll notice a temporary node shows up with a stop button you can use to terminate the process. You'll also see the logs showing the container being created and started. Once the process is complete and the container is created successfully, the temporary node will disappear and a new container will be listed under the containers list. If the process was stopped or had failed, the temporary node would have stayed around with the associated logs and you can delete those when you no longer need them. Looks like our MySQL Docker container has started successfully, and we now have a MySQL database up and running. Let's take a closer look at our container. Similar to images, you can easily view your container information by selecting your container and navigating through the information tabs associated with your container. The first tab will include the logs associated with creating the container. In the second tab, you'll find the logs associated with the application running in your container. You'll often use these logs to debug any issues you're having with your application. The next tab includes general information about your container, including the container's ID. The next three tabs includes the container's environment variables, port bindings, and volume bindings. The Files tab allows you to browse the files inside your running container. The file browser may not work by default for containers that don't have the full LS package, for example, images that are based on Alpine. I can do various operations on my container by right-clicking on it, which includes redeploying or stopping the container. I can also use the exec option to run commands. Let's say I'd like to use the MySQL command line client to create a table and add some data. I'll click exec, then choose create and run, then I'll enter the MySQL command passing in the user and password. Once I click OK, the command executes and I'm now connected to the MySQL client. I can now execute my SQL statements to create my table and enter some data into my table. If at any point you'd like to delete your images or containers, you can do so by selecting the nodes that you'd like to delete and pressing Delete. Let's say we want to create our own image. I have a simple Hello World application that I'd like to build an image for and run in a Docker container. First, I need to create a Docker file. I'll select my project, bring up the new menu by pressing Alt-Insert for Windows and Linux or Command-N for macOS, choose File, then type Docker file. In my Docker file, I can use Control Space to bring up the list of keywords available to me. I'll use the From keyword to specify my base image. I can also use Code Completion to get a list of images available to me. I want to use the OpenJDK image as my base image. Then if I want to specify a tag, I can type the colon and press Control Space to see the available tags. I'll choose the 11 tag corresponding to a Java 11 image. I need to copy my project files into the image, so I'll use the copy command. Then I'll need to specify the directory where my class files exist on my host machine. In my case, they're in the out directory. If you don't see the out directory, you'll need to either build or run your application. For my target directory, I'll just specify the temp directory for my simple app. I'll switch to the temp directory as my working directory, then specify the command to run my main class. Now that I'm done writing my Docker file, I'm ready to build my image and run my container. You can do so by clicking on the gutter icon in your Docker file. I'll create a new run configuration so I can specify all my custom running options. This configuration window looks slightly different than the one we saw earlier. This time, we have two sections, one for building the image and one for running the container. In the build configuration section, I can specify the image's name and tag. I'll call my image Hello World and give it a 1.0 tag. If you want to specify more options when building your images, you can click on Modify Options and enable additional options. For example, you can click on Build Options, which will display the Build Options field. You can use Code Completion to see the options available for your Docker build. I don't need any additional options, so I'll leave this blank. In my Run section, I'll specify a container name. I'll call it MyContainer1. Then I'll go ahead and click Run. IntelliJ IDEA starts a new process, which will first build our image. While our image is building, we see the logs showing the result of executing each instruction in our Docker file, including pulling the OpenJDK 11 image. Once our image is built successfully, IntelliJ IDEA will create MyContainer1 and start it. Looks like our container was created and started successfully, so we see a new container under the containers list. We also see the Hello World message from our application in the log view, which tells us that the application ran successfully in our Docker container. Under Images, we see our Hello World 1.0 image and the OpenJDK 11 image that we specified as the base image in our Docker file. If you want to use the command line to run any Docker images, you can easily do so by switching to the terminal window in IntelliJ IDEA. Let's run another Hello World container and call it MyContainer2. Then I'll specify the image name to use for my container. I execute the command and I see my second container ran successfully and printed out the Hello World message. If we switch back to the services window, we'll see the second container is now listed under my containers list. Now that my image is all ready to go, I want to push it to my repository on Docker Hub. Notice that if you ever want to find something in your services window, you can simply start typing your search string. I'll find my Hello World 1.0 image and right-click on it. Then I'll choose Push Image. I need to specify the information for my registry, so I'll click New. I'm using Docker Hub, so I'll keep the address as is and enter my account credentials. Then I'll enter my repository name. In my case, I'll enter Hello World for my repository name, then 1.0 for my tag. Then I'll click OK. Looks like the push was successful, and if I go to Docker Hub and refresh, I see the new repository. Anyone on my team can now pull my image and run it. For the next portion of the video, let's take a look at how to work with Docker Compose in IntelliJ IDEA. I have a simple web application that takes in values in a form and stores it in a database. I want to create a Docker Compose file to make it easy for anyone to get my application up and running. So I've created a Docker file for my application image, and I'll now create a Docker Compose file to define all the services I need for my application to run. I'll create a new file called docker-compose.yaml. In my Docker Compose YAML file, I can use code completion to help me write my file. I'll specify the first service I need for my application, which is a database service. My application uses MySQL, so I'll choose that for my image. You'll notice that we also get code completion here. Then I'll define my environment variables. You'll notice that IntelliJ IDEA helps us with indentation and inserts the dashes for us. Next, I'll define my web application service. In this case, I'll have Docker Compose build my image off of the Docker file in my current directory. Then I'll bind my ports. Finally, I'll tell Docker Compose that my application service depends on the database service, so it starts the services in the right order. Since I've already defined the database service earlier, IntelliJ IDEA brings it up as a suggestion. And we're done with our Docker Compose file. We're ready to start our application. In order to do so, we can use the gutter icon next to the services key. This is the equivalent of running Docker Compose up. You'll also notice two gutter icons down below by each of my service definition. You can use those icons to start a single service. We now see the logs showing the process running and our services being created. We now see a new type of node for Docker Compose, which provides a grouping for our application services. If we expand our node, we'll see the two services we defined in our Docker Compose file. Under each service, we'll see the running container for that service. We can click on our containers and access their associated logs and information. Now that our application is up and running, let's see if it's working. I'll enter in some information, click Submit, and I see a message telling me that the information was saved, meaning that my database was reached successfully. Great. Now I want to make a small change to my application. I'll open up my index.jsp file and change the title of my form. I'll now try to redeploy my application by clicking on the Compose node in the Services window and clicking on the Deploy button. You'll notice that the logs say that both services are already up to date, even though I have changed my web application. Indeed, if I go to my browser and press F5 to refresh, I see that the form hasn't changed. There are two reasons for this. First, I only changed the JSP file for my application but didn't rebuild my WAR. Second, the default deployment configuration will only build an image if it doesn't already exist. Let's see how we can change that. In my Services window, I'll right-click my Compose node and choose Edit Configuration. In the Docker Compose Up section of the Configuration window, I'll click Modify, choose Build, then click Always, which will force Docker Compose to rebuild my image even if I already built it before. In addition, in the Before Launch section, I'll add a new task to rebuild my WAR file before each deployment. Then I'll click OK. Now let's try deploying again. This time, we see a message in the log saying that the container for my application service was recreated. Now if I refresh my browser, I see the update I made to the application. There are more operations you can do in your services window. For example, you can increase the number of containers running for a service by selecting the service and clicking on the Scale button. IntelliJ IDEA prompts you for the number of containers you'd like to have. I'll choose 3 and click OK. I now see 2 more containers were created and started under my database service, totaling 3 database containers. In this video, we looked at the Docker and Docker Compose features available in IntelliJ IDEA that can help you when developing your applications with Docker. Thanks for watching!